all started with the release of 10.10. Back then we had thousands of users, but after the release we reached almost tens of millions of people. And we were of course doing analytics back then also, but we were using third-party tools, but they were limited and they had problems. So as a constantly evolving company, we wanted to be data informed. So we decided to build our own analytics platform. It has a great community. You can find many libraries online and it's open source, so you can just go and change whatever you want in the language.
Actually, when I came here, we were already using Go for all our backend system. As Onur told you the history of our analytic tools. My background was Python. I was strong on Python, but I was very curious about using Go. So when I dive into the code, I understand that it performs very well and it's very good for a backend system. So I was very happy to use Go here at Graham.
Actually, we are using Go for almost every project that runs on our servers. I mean, the in-house tools, analytics solutions, and the game backends. But if I should choose one of those, I would definitely choose analytics because it's been running for almost 3 years now with almost no downtime. And it's handling billions of events with just a couple of servers. And the resource usage went down during the process thanks to the Go team because they optimized the garbage collection for the three versions, and that helped us a lot.
We are using Go for all our projects here because as we told about, it performs very well and our analytics system is working for I think 3 years, and it has kind of zero downtime here. We are happy about that, and also after that we decided to use Go for our different projects. And also it gives us a bit flexibility because we can use the same library for different projects. So it helps us very well. And also we develop a tool, actually not develop, we took an open source project and then we make some development according to our needs. And it's a workflow manager. It's a kind of workflow manager, and now all our system are working on it, like our ETL process, like our backup systems, or any other DevOps process are working on it, and now it becomes the heart of our system here. And it's all written in Go. It was open source and we develop it, and also it's the best usage of Go, I think, here at Graham.
It's the workflow manager, which we call Gray. It helps us with the DevOps operations on the backend side. Before Gray, we tried many third-party solutions, but none of them really helped us. So we decided to build it. There was an open source project. We forked it and we improved it actually. The tool allows us to build custom flows based on Docker containers. This means that it allows you to create flows of containers, which was not possible before that. So it helped us a lot with the analytics part.
We did a workflow manager, and also our analytics system is working very well for many years. It's very stable. We are happy with that. So I think these two things are the best thing we did in Go here at Graham.
The first one is definitely concurrency. I mean the Go's concurrency model. It provides us to use Go routines, which are like threads, but are not actually threads. And also channels between those, which handles the communication between Go routines. The concurrency model of Go changes the way you think about applications. I mean, you design differently, and I like it a lot. The second one is its tools. that help us with formatting, testing, and benchmarking. And the third one is the defer statement, which allows you to run custom logic before returning from a function. And it helped us a lot with closing open file descriptors and closing connections when necessary.
I think it's the goroutine, the first, and the channel. And I can say that the go-get command, it's like the pip in Python. As I said, I'm coming from Python, and it's very similar to pip. You can install the third-party tools easily with the go-get command. And also, if you are curious about Go, I'm suggesting you to look at the Go routines and the channels, because they are the most important parts of Go.
So we use Go for many projects on the analytics part and in-house stuff. And maybe we have over 20 projects, and we recently started using it for game backends, and probably in the near future we'll be using it for our new games.
We use Go many of our projects and now generally they are not related with the game backend. Generally they are related with the analytics system and the other in-house tools. Now we started to use the Go for our game backend system. Since we are happy with it, so why not we are using it?